I want to walk you now through a quick test for cognitive disorders. So cognitive disorders result primarily from primary or secondary abnormalities of the central nervous system. They can affect memory and orientation, attention, and judgment. The Mini-Mental Status Exam is used to test cognitive function. Now, this is a great screening tool, and it's one that should actually be included in any mental status exam that you do for the patient. It's quick, it's short, it's easy, and again, it's a screening tool, and it'll tell you whether or not you need to dig a little bit deeper into determining if there is, in fact, a cognitive problem. But because errors in cognition can come with all kinds of psychiatric disorders, even general medical conditions. Consider things like depression and psychosis. Sometimes poor memory and concentration can be features of these illnesses. That's why it's really important to get some baseline MMSE on every patient who you encounter. Now, the mini mental status exam, it's also called a Fullstein, it's scored out of 30 points, and really anyone falling below a 26 probably has some problems that need a little digger deeping into figuring out what's going on there with their cognition. So there are a lot of things that you can test for, and again, this is scored out of 30 points. Here's a chart that helps to summarize a little bit about what you're looking for. Things like orientation for the patient. Do they know what the month and year is? Do they know where they are, that it's a hospital, what floor they're on, or whether it's an outpatient clinic, what city they're in, et cetera. So you're really going to score them there based on their orientation. And you're going to want them to name three objects and register them, meaning repeat them right back to you. You want to be able to test for their attention by giving them some calculations or spelling quiz. Now, before you do this step, it's really important that you know the educational level of your patient so that you can tailor the exam to meet them where they're at. You want to know about their recall. So you ask them to repeat the three words they had registered 5 minutes previously. And then you're going to score patients by asking them to name simple objects like a pen and a clock, ask them to repeat a sentence after you, and give them a three-step command to follow. So other things that you're going to do is see how well they can complete tasks. Tell them to close their eyes, have them write a sentence, and have them copy a design, which should be three-dimensional and something that they're able to construct without problem. So you'll score all of this. And in summary, the mini mental status exam is testing all kinds of things: orientation, alertness, patient's language skills. You're testing their executive functioning, their recall, their memory. You may also, as part of this exam, throw in some abstractions to see how well they can join objects together. Do they know that an apple and an orange are similar because they're fruits? That's a good example of an abstract thinker. Whereas somebody who's more concrete is going to say, well, they're both round, which is not so good of an answer. So I want to tell you about two other quick tests that you can do in terms of checking cognition. So sometimes these come up on exams and on the wards, so they're worth noting. Now, when you're suspecting a cognitive disorder in a patient, let's say you've screened them with the mini mental status exam, they didn't do so well, so you want to take it one step further and maybe give them a MOCA, the Montreal Cognitive Assessment. This is, again, a brief screening tool. It only takes about 10 minutes to deliver, and it really tests a variety of things. It can test, compared with the MMSE, it tests things that are a little more sensitive to the detection of a mild cognitive impairment. Okay, so there's a wider range of domains here that you're looking at, including memory and language, attention, also visual spatial things, and executive function. For example, the MOCA includes little quizzes like drawing a clock, telling it to say a certain time. It includes a trail making sequence. They test how quickly a person can name words starting with a certain letter within a minute. So it's just a little bit more challenging than the MMSE and a little bit more nuanced. There's also a test called the Mini-Cog, and this is a clock drawing test and also a test of recall. And this can be really important and a really quick way to assess whether or not somebody's having some cognitive trouble. The clock drawing test is a great way to really see if people are able to connect a sequence of ideas and strategize and do something in a goal-oriented, task-driven way. And then with recall of three words, you can really quickly just see how somebody's memory is based off of whether they can recall all three words easily or if it's a struggle to even come up with one. So the advantages of the Mini-Cog, again, are the high sensitivity for predicting dementia, the short testing time, because it really takes only a couple of minutes compared to the mini mental status exam or MOCA, which may take about 7 to 10 minutes each. And there is a little bit of diagnostic value that's limited in the Mini-Cog because it's so short, but it's a good way to just clue you in as to whether or not there might be a serious cognition problem that you need to dig deeper for. So you're familiar now with a few quick screening tools. I'd say for your exam, the one to remember is the mini mental status exam. And note that this is important to do not only in patients who may have cognitive trouble, but really you should include it as part of your mental status exam for all patients.